that was quite an intro. Welcome back. If that intro wasn't enough, well, then maybe the opening lyrics will remind you.
I never can say goodbye. No, 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 I...
All right. What we're looking at today is the blending of the vocal modes. First of all, it's a little bit cryptic trying to figure out what all the voices are doing, and I think I've got my head around it now, so that's one thing. I chose this song because it's quite a good demonstration of going from soft vocal to a belting vocal. From what I gathered, they've used the variations to create this default voice, which gets more powerful as the notes get higher. So it's not uncommon for singers going for higher notes and belting it out, and they need that power to do it. So that's what's been done, but it's not always the way you want to do things, because sometimes someone can sing high notes in a soft voice. That's why these come into play. Let's just move down to here-ish. And this line.
Don't want to let you go. Hey, I never can.
Okay, that is the default voice. And when she hits that go, it just sounds, she's building up. You can hear it. She's building up, but then she hits the highest note and it's kind of like, go.
Don't want to let you go.
What you want is the power voice in there.
Don't want to let you go. Hey.
But you don't want necessarily it the whole time. You may want to build up to that high note. We can blend these in real time using the parameter graph. So let's just do a quick version of that. I'm actually going to change the voice to light.
Don't want to let you go.
So we're going to start with light. It's at 100%. And then we're going to bring in the power along this. And at the moment, so I need to activate it. Power, power. So you just click on there once it gives you that little message. And the idea here is I want it to gradually get up to that note. So I'm going to double click and add some points. And at the moment, I'll just start halfway up because I don't know how powerful power is. And I'm going to ramp it up, see how that goes.
Don't want to let you go.
That's pretty good. But once more power.
Don't want to let you go.
Right, not bad. And then we want to bring it down again. Because we don't necessarily want to stay in full power the whole time.
Don't want to let you go. Hey, I never can.
So that's good. And there are times when you actually need to animate down the original voice because the blend may not suit it. Like we want to go full power, then I need to animate the light down. So if I leave this display on power and switch to light and then activate that, I can see the power line here. And I can counteract that by adding points to. So I could drop that down. In fact, let's use this one. So I could crossfade it, basically.
Don't want to let you go!
So now I have the full power, not half mixed with the light voice, for that range. And then, of course, if I liked what it was doing here, I then have to add a new point and bring that back. Just delete this one for a sec, if I can get at it.
Don't want to let you go. Hey, I never can.
Okay, pretty good. Now imagine you've got to do this for a whole song. And imagine that you're doing a whole bunch of songs. I've done some work with a company called Top Dots. And what they are is they will make musical transcriptions, i.e. sheet music. So that's all the parts. It's the bass, it's the horns, it's the strings, it's the vocals, it's the backing vocals, all of that. Instead of just making a MIDI file to demonstrate what that actual sheet music is portraying, they've decided, let's up the production and basically make covers of these, and we'll use Synth V to do the vocals. I've been doing some consulting with them, and they were kind enough to let me use this for this demo, and here we are. How do we blend the voices in a more efficient way? And the secret is really, on the surface, quite simple. Basically, you don't want to do any animation, like I've just done, and you want to go back to your voices, and you basically choose the voices you want to be blending between. So I'm going to choose, like I said, I'll start with light, and then I will just export that as a light version, right? I'll type it in here, I'll say light, and then I'll export that. And then I'll also change it to power, and I'll export that. In fact, I did all of them, just to be sure. And so I would change that to power and export that. I'll have all 8 versions of the vocal modes, all for the entire length of the song. And then in Cubase, I'll do the mixing between. Okay, here we are in Cubase. I have the backing track up here. So that already has the backing vocals mixed in. And then I have all 8 vocal modes from Synth V. So let's just have a quick audition.
Don't wanna let you go. 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 Don't wanna let you go.
Okay, as you can see, sort of a repetition going on here. There's like a power voice that gets blended to create the clear voice and passionate voice, maybe even the solid one. And then the others are like the default, simple. In fact, the soft voices sound similar to the light voice, but just maybe EQ'd darker with some more aspiration layer, kind of higher in the mix. So really, there's 2 modes. There's soft and loud, which makes a lot of sense. So here's the 2 voices we want, the power lead and the light lead. I've already put some effects on because those vocals need a bit of taming. So I've got an EQ on the light lead, and I've got soothe and dynamic EQ and some compression on the power lead. What we're here to see is how to simplify blending between these two. This all stems from me trying to figure out an easy way for the guys at Top Dots to mix between the soft and the loud voice, basically in real time, and record that in as an animation, which gives you the power to tweak it quite quickly. The main thing is that there's none of this kind of sitting there in the parameters and working with squiggly lines. You're basically just doing it by feel. But there's a few steps that need to be taken, and I will show you them now. It all boils down to a free plugin from, you guessed it, Melda Production. As you know, I'm a big fan. I'm not sponsored, but if they're giving us free plugins that work well, then why not, right? So there's this thing called M-Ratio. And what it basically means is I can blend from one sound to another with constant power, so there's no dip in the middle. And that's all there is to it. But there are a couple of caveats, and that's what I'm going to show you now. So, 0 is the voice that you've dropped it on. I've put it on the light voice here. So if I was to blend this to 100 right now,
don't wanna let you go.
It blends it down to silence because there's nothing there yet. So the way you do that is, I need to open this channel, and then I use a sidechain. Power lead, activate it. Okay, and because I've done that, I need to put it to no bus. So it's not feeding the stereo bus anymore. It's just going to the side chain. And now what'll happen is I should be able to blend between the two.
Don't wanna let you go. Hey, I never can say goodbye, boy.
It's not perfect yet, so because if you listen, when I'm blending, let's actually go to 50%. That's probably the most obvious spot. So here's a half blend between power lead and the light lead.
Don't wanna let you go.
I can tell they're not perfectly aligned, and there could be various reasons for this, but bottom line is that they need to be phase locked. Now, within Synthesizer V, they will be phase locked because it's one MIDI file playing the two voices. But once you render them out, MIDI itself is not really super accurate in audio terms. And if I was just cutting between these, right? So if I just played the light lead and then cut at a certain point and took over with the power lead, no biggie. No one's going to hear that. But when you try and blend them, you do hear it. Now, this one does require a paid plugin. I don't know. There may be other ways of doing this, but I mean, you could manually try and line it up, but good luck. The easiest way to do it that I know is another plugin, again, from Melda Production, and it's called M Auto Align. So if I put that after all the effects I've added on the power voice, and then I put it before the ratio, when I run the auto align, it'll bring these two voices into sync before the ratio mix, right? Because you need them to be, everything has to happen before the ratio mix in order for it to actually be locked properly. So let's just run this before I do the auto align at 50%.
Don't want to let you go.
Now I will just use the auto align.
Don't wanna let you go. Hey, I never can say.
And after the auto align?
Don't wanna let you go. Hey, I never can say goodbye, boy.
Still a little bit of weirdness, but generally it just feels tighter. And of course, the idea is that we're not going to be sitting on a 50% mix. We're basically using this as a real-time way of emphasizing. So let's just give an example of that. So I'm just going to twiddle this knob here and
don't want to let you go. Hey, I never can say goodbye, boy.
So that works quite well. Now, there's another caveat in that because Melda Production plugins usually have so many potential parameters that can be automated, you have to create a macro that controls the ratio knob in order for you to animate it and record the animations. We're actually on this one here for ratio. And it's dead simple. Just click on utilities and you have two slots here. So if I click on the hamburger menu thingy here, say clear and learn, that makes sure there's nothing been saved in there. And all I have to do is move this, the full range, and then stop recording. And if I click on this one more time, it opens up the parameter controls. And I'm just going to put in here ratio in the ratio group. And if I want, I can give it a color. I'm leaving it on percents, and the default will be at 50%. That's fine. And the range is 0 to 100, and you can see the parameters controlled is the ratio. Okay, so that's that. We're ready to animate this ratio control now, but we don't use this knob, remember, we use this one here, because otherwise the automation data won't be written. So I just hit the W, hit play, and then I will do some real-time vocal blending. Okay, that should be enough. Let's go and play it back. And I'm going to take the backing track off so you can hear exactly what's going on.
I never can say goodbye. No, 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 I never can say goodbye. Every time I think I have had enough and start heading for the door, there's a very strange vibration piercing me right to the core. It says, turn around, you fool, you know you love him more and more. Tell me why. Is it so? Don't wanna let you go. Hey, I never can say goodbye, boy. Oh, baby, I never can say goodbye. No, 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 no.
I think that's a lot easier than using the graphs in Synthesizer V, and a lot more powerful. Like I said, I can use things like Soothe and Dynamic EQs and all sorts on the voices before they're blended, which you can't do if you're blending them all in Synthesizer V. So this is a very powerful technique, and it's actually pretty easy. I was just doing this all in real time. I can go in and edit any moments that I messed up on. But the best thing is I can get, if I know the song, and if you've been working on it long enough, you definitely know the song. You know when to push the vocals, when to drop them back. And it's a lot easier to do it in a 3-minute song. It'll take you 3 minutes. I can't imagine how long people spend using only the graph curves in Synthesizer V. Okay, so of course the last thing to do here is to take both of these tracks and send them to a bus or group track or sub mix, whatever you want to call it. And I will just call it Vocal Blend and give that a new color. The thing to remember, of course, is that you don't want your power lead vocal going to that. You want it back to no bus. That way it's only the vocal blend that we're hearing now, but it's both these channels. And if for whatever reason there's a volume difference, you can literally just move the fader. So that's it. Hope you found this technique useful. I certainly am using it all the time now. And I'll see you soon. I never can.